So one of the things that we need to do in Washington State, we need to follow kind of the pathway that's been laid down in some of our sister states. We need to relax the rules of evidence and procedure that apply in matters that are being heard before the Workers' Compensation Board. There is literally no reason we need to have the same strict rules of evidence and procedure that apply to huge corporations like Ford or Apple or Toshiba. It's offensive that we maintain the strict rules of evidence and procedure that we have because it doesn't really match the way regular people speak. And so, for example, many of the injured workers that come before the board are people with less than master's degrees with education. They typically are very blue collar. They typically have very set patterns of communication. And they will talk to you about things like, you know, I went to the doctor and the doctor said this. Well, already right there, you violated one of the rules of evidence, which is the rule against hearsay. In Washington, we have these strict rules, but workers' compensation systems have been moderated in other states, like, for example, New York. New York has relaxed rules of evidence and procedure. I personally practiced there for 5 years, and we didn't lose any kind of formality or effective adjudication of our cases by at least allowing regular people to speak as regular people will. The reality here is that if you actually go to court and you listen to the way the rules of evidence and procedure are kind of used as weapons against our injured workers, there's no reason for that. All of our judges are classically trained. They've all gone to law schools. They all understand what's hearsay, what's not hearsay. They all understand the underlying public policy of allowing reliable information in and keeping reliable information out. We need to allow our injured workers to speak as they will when they go to court so that they can both feel comfortable when they're testifying and so that juries will understand them better and get a greater identity with those people that are having their cases put on before the board. No reason in the world to keep strict rules of evidence and procedure. All of the evidence that comes into a case can be effectively moderated and controlled by the industrial appeals judge at the point it's being admitted, but we should let people speak normally. Now, one other area where it would change the way the process occurs at the board. In New York, if you have your neurosurgeon's treatment note and you say, look, my doctor said this, and you have this treatment note and everybody knows who the local doctors are because, you know, those doctors appear time and time again. You can check them out. You can investigate whether or not they have a license at the Department of Health. You can make sure that essentially their treatment note is their treatment note. But if the injured worker in New York brings their treatment note and the doctor has given a statement about what's going on in their case, we then just believe the doctor. But here in Washington, our injured workers can't bring the treatment note. They literally have to bring the doctor. And it costs thousands of dollars an hour for our injured workers to bring a neurosurgeon to court, or to bring orthopedic surgeons, or to bring occupational medicine, pulmonologist, to bring all the people necessary to support that injured worker's case may cost thousands, even tens of thousands of dollars because we have such strict rules of evidence and procedure. And what that does is it means that a lot of people simply get priced out of the justice system. They can't bring all of those people at all of those costs to court, and we don't allow them to simply bring treatment notes. In New York, you bring a treatment note, you say, see what my doctor said. The judge then offers the other side the opportunity to go cross-examine the doctor if somebody has any doubts or questions about what the treatment note stands for. And the system works at a lower cost in a way that's much more practical for a workers' compensation system. We're not doing that in Washington. We are instead running a system that's excessively offensive and expensive to the injured worker, and we've got to stop. The legislature has got to change this. We need relaxed rules of evidence and procedure.